right? So would you think that it would be really an excellent and tell something, a word about you? Do we really know each other? Do I really know myself, what kind of a CEO I am? And what kind of a CEO are you? And this award is really about that. Even if you may not recognize yourself, but others are noticing you. So this second edition of Nigerian Most Respected CEO Award celebrates the achievements of leaders, how emotionally, intelligently they work towards the growth of the company. And the team management, the initiative they take to make the organization a better place for the people to really enjoy the work. CEO leads the development of the organization short-term and long-term strategy. Now, NG Biz Executive, the business extension unit of Business Executive Media Group in Abuja, in partnership with many organizations, is therefore proud to host the Nigeria Most Respected CEO Awards for second year and celebrate the CEO who have shown unmatched dedication and initiative for their business and colleagues over the past years. The most successful CEO continually adopt, inspire, elevate, and appreciate their team. They keep on inspiring and they go along with their team. These traits have become even more apparent during recent time, when we know that it was a testing time during the COVID time. How we still manage to inspire our team, how we still manage to grow in our own capacity, whatever capacity that time we were able to utilize. And these business leaders should be commended and spotlighted for their extraordinary efforts. And that's why this CEO Awards are quite meaningful for all of us. We wish to welcome all the esteemed guests, nominee and awardees, members of the corporate communities, diplomat members, on behalf of the award committee and organizer, I congratulate each one of you for your unmatched dedication, commitment, creativity, and great leadership skills you have. Many businesses have seen recently dramatic shift in the work culture, as I said, because of the COVID time. And they started moving on to the digital place. And I believe that many leaders were actually struggling to keep a track on their teams. I'm sure you must be also feeling that. However, having your own emotional intelligence, team management skills, all the leaders came up with a great strategy and managed their team. We all have risen to meet these challenges with decisive action and a forward-thinking approach, ensuring that our employees and colleagues thrive in a productive, positive, and creative workplace. And from here on, I would like to again congratulate each one of you for such a remarkable work you have been doing and bringing the community together, elevating, appreciating your team, and let the community and this Nigeria grow substantially. Please, I would like to welcome again. So give a big round of applause for all the awardees, for all the nominees. This is not a big round of applause. I wish you to applaud for you and for you, each one of you. You are not really appreciating yourself. It has to be loud enough to appreciate. And I would say that I definitely would like to appreciate myself, and one word for me is I'm remarkable.
Woo! That's it!
So, and ask yourself what you are. Just the one word for you. And thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of the evening, and I'm proud of all of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, madam. Thank you so much. We preach. Let's practice what we just learned now. He's been a CEO. I know a lot of work. My boss in the office, towards the end of the month, I know they think a lot about, oh my God, salary. When are you going to pay salary? So the person will be thinking, I need to pay this salary. You've been through a lot. I know the situation in the country has not been fantastic. The ease of doing business, understand what is going on. And now with the new newly issued Naira notes and the restrictions. How am I going to handle this whole issue? Because it's going to be a different kind of terrain for everybody. Look at yourself, think up something very nice and look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor something. Nigeria, shege. Look at your neighbor and tell your, if they look at your neighbor, ask your neighbor, do you understand what she just said? Thank you. So look at yourself, think up something. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor that thing you think at you in the face and tell you, I am amazing. So look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor that wonder. I want to hear your voices. If you don't have a neighbor, talk to yourself. Tell yourself that ginger, like, you know. Okay, no, I'm not sure I had that. At this point in time, nobody wants to be Father Christmas. I've never seen many growth move on to the next level. Actually, totally amazing. So we're just going to have a quick game, quickly before... I'm going to need... Okay, let me come to... Oh, these bros, they can't talk. Bros, it's like you people like to sit down at the back of the... lecturer has passed the time, they'll start clapping for the lecturer. You know that clap? Yeah, I think it's time for you to go, sir. I think you guys were one of those people. Hello, sir. I love your heart. Tell us your name. You want to delegate your introduction to somebody else. Let's put our hands together for him. He's not, you can do it. I like that. That's the spirit. Uh-huh. Thank you, Mother and Jane, for the spirit of positivity. He's spreading himself just a few. If you ask your neighbor to repeat what he said or what she said, I'm going to come and meet you and I'm going to find you. What did you just say the last time about yourself? Don't tell the person, please. If I raise up your hand and tell me to come and meet him or her. So you are thinking. Tell us your name, what company you represent. If you are a CEO, Buga, like, okay, that's fine, but you can be a CEO. This young man said about himself.
Olukotun Stephen Friday. He's my brother, the CEO of Sabadot Technology. He said he's hero. He's an hero. That's what he said.
Are you a hero? Is that what you said? Let's put our hands together for this hero. Thank you. Into the mic, please.
My name is Damilola Technology. So he said, being a CEO is a blessing. So.
The way you are squinting your eye looks like, bros, no get time, but I might just leave you alone. Was that what you said? Oh, you even wrote it. Please, let's clap for this man. He's, you are paying attention. Let's put hands together for this. So, Madam Jane, I'm going to ask you, how long have you been in Nigeria?
But I feel that I am already Nigerian.
Ah! Should we give her a name? We should give her a name. Do you give a baptismal name here? So, where you've listened to her speak, right? You know the kind. So, what part of Nigeria do you think she would come from? This is not profiling right now. Don't get me twisted. I'm just... So automatically, you're an Igbo woman. Do you know any Igbo name? If you don't, please don't tell her. It's fine, Abby. Do you know any Igbo name?
No, I don't know.
Do you understand?
You only know, but we have not... You need to meet know the person.
Absolutely, right? And you're in the right...
Surrounded by those people.
It's okay.
Maybe one or two from the you know,
from Ibadan.
That was like completely having a water everywhere. That was so much that I couldn't think of even again taking it.
Thank you so very much, Ma, for, you know, for agreeing to do this. Let's know your name, then you give her the name you want to give.
Good evening, everyone. I am Rosemary by name. Okay, we want to christen her, right?
Yes.
Okay, I am with my friend, Ladi Morales. But my business name is Honey the Love Skincare.
Wow.
Thank you. That's why I said Ngozi. We all know the meaning of Ngozi now. It's God's blessing. Yes.
Is that the full?
Yes. So we christen her in the name of the Father.
Oh.
All right. So ladies and gentlemen, what's your Igbo name now?
Ngozi.
It's okay, we'll give you 7/10. Let's put our hands together for her. Thank you so very much. It's nice to meet you, Ngozi. Thank you. Great, absolutely. Pull out audio visual that we're going to play. It's supposed to be an address from the lead organization of...
local and international awards, associations, conferences, and corporate workshops. NGBiz, which organizes awards, magazine publications, associations, conferences, and corporate workshops. International Business Council, IBC, which serves as a chamber of commerce and industry for enterprises within the African Continental Free Trade Area. The Africa Chamber for Trade, which serves as a pan-continental register of enterprises worthy of serving as trade counterparties and investment partners, which contributes to the success of the African Continental Free Trade Area. Teluap is a subsidiary under the group, which is an event organization and management company. Our services include third-party event management services, product and project launch, brand visibility, attendance management services, ushering and protocol services, corporate event planning and coordination, logistics and equipment rentals, staff and visitors digital logging, programming, exhibition and roadshows, executive training program, and practical communication masterclass. And the Executive Foundation, which is a non-profit organization responsible for community development in rural areas, skills training and empowerment. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, introducing The Group. The Group is a business powerhouse, and under its umbrella is the Business Executive.
Before I dance and drop microphone now, they will not complete my money for me. Please don't spoil my show for me. So, present stepped into the room. I actually introduced him and every other person as regards security issues. So while the keynote address was going on, one handsome young man who we see on TV most times talking about security matters stepped into the room. And just in case you missed the introduction, which I did in his absentia, I'll just do that quickly again. Let's put our hands together, ladies and gentlemen, before I introduce him, because this man is somebody who has earned the respect that we are giving to him today. Ambassador Dr. Roy Ohidivi. I'm going to tell him to please correct me, because his name has more consonants than vowels, and we are not used to, you know, pronouncing double consonants like that. He's going to teach me how to pronounce his name. He's a military veteran. A fellow of the International Security, is a chartered mediator and conciliator, provides strategic solutions to security problems, and this man has a PhD in peace studies and conflict resolution. He has earned his doctorate degree. So ladies and gentlemen, we are not going to allow him rest and gist with people and everybody. Let's put our hands together for Ambassador Roy Ohidivi, as he comes to give us his goodwill speech and corrects me on how to pronounce his name. Thank you so very much. Thank you.
And you didn't tell me what is inside. Well, good evening, everybody. I'm sorry I arrived in traffic. I have arrived late, and I apologize for arriving late. If you need to know the reason, give me the new Naira note. If that today we are meeting with CEOs, am I correct? And we are trying to enlighten the environment and lighten your mood. Because to be a CEO in Nigeria, you should be running a whole state in US. Agreed? I have graduates, I have close to 700 staff or more. I have graduates that didn't graduate. I have people that are ghost workers that are also collecting money of another ghost worker. So I need to have an auditor to audit the accounts. And the auditor we go to LRS and FRS and jointly audit the account with them. And an accountant told me, say, Oga, leave us now. If Ministry of Finance fit pad budget, this small one where we do you, now you the best. Oga, it's just 700 and something thousand. It's not up to your flight when you are going to US, see your family. An accountant. He's in detention. He's telling me it's not, it's small money. What is happening in Ministry of Finance? So to be a CEO in Nigeria is not beans. I tell people. You buy a generator to increase your performance because the government has not gotten enough power for you. The generator needs to be fueled. And the facility manager relates properly, when I say properly, I mean properly, with the diesel supplier. And incidentally, they supply bad diesel to you. It damages your generating set. And the same facility manager calls another crooked generator repairer. Meanwhile, you are going on downtime. What will you do when you discover that you have been sold bad diesel? And a bad technician has also checked your generator and see you. Am I talking to CEOs? The next thing is to call the police, right? I hope there is no police officer here. I'm a retired army officer. Please don't arrest me. You now call the police. You now pay for two things first. The first one is mobilization. No, this first one is approval. I see somebody smiling. Have they done it to you? You pay for approval of the case of your petition, then you pay for mobilization. That is if you are paying direct, but if you are paying through your CSO or your head of security or your admin manager or HRO, instead of 100,000, you may be paying 150. When you discover, the staff will tell you, Oga, I just say me I add that one in case they ask me for extra. You know how police they be. So in case they didn't ask you for extra, will you return the 50,000? No. You know, so these are the things that we see running business in Nigeria. It's pathetic. So when I see someone saying they are CEOs, I beat my chest. I just started LLC now in the US. And they say, just register LLC. I say, I need a lawyer. I say, for what? Oh, yeah, sit down. We sit down with laptop. I say, which one? Do you pay for this or you pay for this? Which state do we domicile? And I discovered that New York and California, and they have different law, different. It's not like I just arrive at Abuja and I say, what's up? I arrive at Port Harcourt. No. You can run foul with applying the policy in one state to the other. You know? And I saw a guy that had office, he was shaking that he has not paid his bill. I said, so wait here, they will reject, they'll throw you out. But in Nigeria, you call somebody where you put your property, he's telling you, Oga, wait here now. You want to eject someone, you will pay Agbero money, you will pay, you will pay police money. You know, so all of these things are just so, so bad. You know, one of our building was looted. Items were taken away, worth about 20-something million. Lawyer of your company is talking to is there any lawyer here? Don't be angry. We are CEOs talking here. We are talking about, has this thing happened to anybody? Am I connecting? Lawyer is talking to the other company lawyer. Okay, what's the problem? No, I'm talking to the lawyer of the other firm. We are trying to find a middle point. And I am a fellow in the Institute of Chartered Mediators and Conciliators. We have like 60% senior advocates in Nigeria. So I quickly call one or two son there. I say, bros, I know, say, as a son now, to call yourself is 2 million. But please, oh, my lawyer is talking to the other company lawyer. He say, when? They went out of court. They were talking. He said, Ambassador, discharge that guy immediately. Let me send you somebody. He sent a lawyer from his office to arrive the scene. And I told the lawyer, bros, stand down. And that lawyer immediately detected that the two other lawyers were putting a markup to present for mediation and arbitration, ADR. CEOs, why is it like this now? There are two cars that run for mainland for my security company. When I came back from US in November, I saw the requirements they need. I looked at the tires. They bought new tires. Where are the old ones? Usually you bring the old one. And I saw this, saw that. I said, okay. I just told the guy, I stood upstairs, I told my driver, and the guy was suspecting. I said, I want to change my tires. These vehicle tires are bad. They said, okay, sir, we're coming. I said, go to Oyinbo, where they buy brand new tires. They went to the guy that does organizer, that piles up these bad tires on the road, and went, they were washing it there. Wash it, everything, take something to put lining like this, and bring it, and the admin manager will come down and look at it like this, as if they don't know what's happening, you know. Go around, look at it like this, come up, write a report, everything. I called all of them to my office, I reviewed the camera. I said, this person, he looked like you, just went down on his knees. I'm sorry, sir, my wife is not well. Who is your wife? Me that used to buy things for all of your wives. They don't know. I send recharge cards to my staff wives. Some of those ones are in critical position. Can send you 10K at a time. So when you say you are not well, your wife will tell me, Daddy is well. It's okay. CEOs. How many of you have gotten the list now for Christmas? They need Christmas things. Okay, I said anybody that brought contracts, okay, can get Christmas thing because I give commission from the jobs you bring. Okay, I'm a retired military officer. I'm the national secretary for retired members of Nigerian forces. So anytime you have seen veterans protesting, I'm the one that locked the gate of Ministry of Defense last 3 months. So I run a security company, I do background checks, I do investigation, I sell pump action, bulletproof vest, I do all of those kind of things. You know, so, and I looked at my people, I said, see what we will do. This our commission that we give for people that bring contracts. I am seeing this man's name and this lady's name as co-commission people. They say, yes, sir, we got the contract together. I said, okay. Okay, no problem. Now, I'm going to give bonus to anybody that brought commission, that brought contracts. Secret started to leak, sir. I got SMS, sir, that contract, that bonus is to me. I said, ah, but you say you are co-owners. He said, no, it's to me. And sir, that contract is not that amount. There is another amount, the 300,000 on top. We used to share it with the admin of the other company, so they don't know too. I see. CEOs, how do we survive? My company does background checks for microfinance bank, for banks. We are one of the people doing background checks for Access Bank and some other banks, you know, because I do local and international. You know, background checks, due diligence check. I do investigation, undercover investigation. I've started the first private investigation school in Nigeria called Private Eye Academy to be launched next year. Now, I now looked at this matter seriously. If a company that gave me 10 people to do background check for, and the staff made it 15, an account approved money for 15, but the database with us is 10. So for that 5, my staff, we take 2. The other company staff, we take 3. Two CEOs looking at each other like this, their money passing under like this. So, if you are a CEO in Nigeria, you are a wonderful person. Let's put our hands together for ourselves. For those of us that are not CEO, that you follow Oga come, don't let Oga look at you too much. You are not among, eh? If you are among, he won't bring you here. And don't hate me so much. But one thing I know about this event and this madam that does this thing, last time the husband was here too, you know, this recognition, as small as it may look like, it reduces your trauma. It reduces what you have gone through. I'm going to some countries next year, and it's still for this award thing. But anytime I take an award, I used to remember the fallen heroes in the Nigerian military. I used to remember my colleagues in the army that died. And the same country still raped and plundered the family they left behind. So if you own a business here in Nigeria, it is agreed that you are running a whole country by yourself, providing water, providing light, providing your own security. Because I just realized that if you take a case to a police station where your company is, if they are not fair to your company, feel you. Who knows how to feel? If they are not fair to you, that case will not fly anywhere. Ah, Oga, you know you are an army officer. Yes, Oga, come this way. You see, that company, they don't do anything for us. I say, what should they do for you? They pay tax. So, I am here to encourage you. Do more. Open more doors. Because the more of us that are advantaged to give employment, the more of us that have removed so many people. Don't look at the bad eggs. Don't look at the bad eggs. Let's do more. Let's collaborate more. Collaboration is better than competition. Collaboration and partnership open your doors wider. I speak for so many companies outside Nigeria. And it gives a lot of influence. In the absence of time, I know we need to look at time. I would like to stop here for now.
Ambassador Roy wants to take my job. What among the categories that were nominated? Iwolokan. Did I try? Clap for me now. Which is the commercial cleaning services? Needed to, you know, go on with this. Okay, great.
Commercial cleaning service category. The nominees are director, Lost in Wires. In the commercial cleaning service category.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let us put our hands together for the awardee for this category, commercial cleaning services. No other person or no other company than Dust and Wipes, represented by BC Teru. Let's put our hands together, ladies and gentlemen, as they come get the awards. They deserve it. All right, for the next category, which is agrochemicals, let us take a look at who the nominees are.
In
in the architecture category. The nominees are Tunde Oyekola, CEO, El Mansour Atelier, Olajumoke Adeniyi, CEO, Ad Consulting Limited, Mosu Ogunba, CEO, More Art Architecture, Layo Badi, CEO, Our Forces Nigeria Limited, and Mr. Obeyi Iyamapo, Principal, Armark Consultants.
Hands together. You.
In the agrochemical category, the nominees are Dr. Emmanuel I. Ajayi, MDCEO, Biostat Company, Dr. Mattis A. Awuzisayo, MDCEO, Harvest Fields Industries Limited, Dr. Monday Abu, MDCEO, Saro Agro Sciences Limited, Onajite Paul Okoro, Chairman, Tore Chemical Industries, Ogunwunde Olayinka Ogunwunde, Founder, Hemingwell Company Limited, Tochukwu C. Orajia, MDCEO, Vitacare Nigeria Limited, and Adewole Ibadan, MDCEO, Choice Agrochemicals Limited.
And the person who will be coming up to collect the award is no other person than Ogunrinde Olayinka Oluwole of Hemingwell Company Limited. As he goes back to his seat, that is a well done from the Nigeria Most Respected CEOs Awards. Thank you. The next category.
In the food manufacturing category, nominees are Ademola Akinde, CEO, Green Tech Industries, Suleiman Ademola Adekola, CEO, Right Foods Limited, Folatope Babalola Ayesima, GMD CEO, UAC of Nigeria PLC, Engineer Shegun Olai, CEO, Ayola Foods, and Ladi Foods, CEO, Ladi Foods Integrated Foods.
And the award goes to no other person than Ladi Foods, Ladi Foods Integrated Farms Limited. Let's put hands together for the mighty woman. Let's put hands together for her.
Them don't they notice? I'm not joking. All my guys, them know me.
Hi, so my name is Ladi Moras. I am the founder and CEO of Ladi Moras Integrated Farms Limited. If there's one thing Ladi Moras Integrated Farms Limited is known for, it's our democratic form of leadership. And this has led us into achieving greater things within a short period of time. I dedicate this award to my team and to my family and friends who have been there for me right from the idea stage to this very point. I know that the stakeholders already have all the policies and the guidelines laid out, so they only need to implement and to automate them so as to achieve efficient results.
And that is from the awardee. Let's put our hands together for her once again. Owls. Oh, I beg your pardon. My bad. Actually, cyber tech, artificial intelligence. So do we go for...
In the textile manufacturing category, the nominees are Prince Apple, MD CEO Beyond Clothing Nigeria, Mr. Franklin Egbamu, MD, Federal Green Nigeria Limited, Bilal Jose Rata, CEO, Garment Factory, Adidoko Adiola, CEO, Global T-shirt Factory, and Naomi Abosede Onade, Managing Director, Ready to Wear Nigeria Limited.
And the award goes to Adeola Kabir Adedokun, Global T-Shirt Factory. Let's put hands together for the gentleman.
Adedokun Kabir Adeola is a highly enterprising Nigerian. He is a young man who is determined and focused. He has made invaluable contributions to the textile industry, particularly in the area of garmenting and branding. He is the founder and director of Global T-Shirt Factory, which is based in Nigeria with intention to set up a new base in East Africa. Adeola, an indigene of Kwara State, was born in Lagos. His secondary school was Solomon Grace International School. He was at Covenant University, where he earned a bachelor degree in architecture. He is currently taking a master degree program in business strategy and entrepreneurship at Cardiff University in the United Kingdom. Adeola holds a master class certificate from the Tufts Business School, and he is also a member of the Lagos Chamber of Commerce and Industry, ADEDIC.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us put our hands together for Eniolorunda Oguniyi of CyberDot Technology, the man who actually wraps his name.
CyberDot Technologies is an artificial intelligence company founded in Lagos in 2018, which now has its headquarters in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, USA. The company has been nominated as the most promising artificial intelligence service provider in 2022 by the CIO Review in Problem-Solving Solutions. Our mission is to build innovative solutions with excellence and cutting-edge technology that provide the highest quality and most reliable services across all sectors.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear the nominees for the category of property management. All right, so in the absence of the availability
equipment suppliers category, the nominees are Dr. Nathan Ouachukwu, CEO Labstock Nigeria Limited; Adegbenga Dari Ismail, CEO Lake Link Medical and Laboratory Limited; Princess Adigbeju Ogunleye, CEO Peter and Jane Limited; Oluwadamilola Ajadi, MD Tunex Laboratories Engineering Limited; and Mr. Ilekuba Echezola Ken, CEO Kenny Medical Company, KMC Diagnostic Limited.
Princess Adigbeju Bemi Ogunleye of Peter and Jane Limited. Let's put our hands together. Luwatobi Victor Oladile of FIPS Multilinks Limited. Let's put our hands together, ladies and gentlemen, as he steps on the stage to receive his well done. Of Tech Vantage Innovation, ladies and gentlemen, Oshé.
To flip the script, I don't mean hi. My name is Teva, and I know you're facing one business challenge or the other. I have no fear. It's time to flip the script, I don't mean literally.
Take advantage of IT solutions with Tech Vantage. Miss Lola owns a fashion business and she was wondering how she could break into the online space. This client is facing a similar challenge that requires a website with a responsive engine for Miss Lola, tailored for a fashion business. Get it? Fashion? Tailored? Get it? Contact us today for your IT solution, maintenance, and development. Tech Vantage, solve business challenges with IT.
In the environmental services category, the nominees are John Savida, Managing Director, The Cleaners Council Pro Nigeria, Bisola Ronsenwe, Managing Director, Squeaky Clean Services Limited, Onwukwe Morin Kelechi, CEO, Kalmao Global Services, Mudupe Sembanjo, Group CEO, Mosen Cleaning Services Limited, and BC Teru, Managing Director, Dust and Wipes.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for no other person than Onwukwe Morin Kelechi of Kalmao Global Services, the beautiful lady in white.
Kalmao Global Services Nigeria Limited. We operate our multidisciplinary ventures in the following areas: procurement, cleaning services, and construction services. Our vision: to be the foremost customer-centric company in Nigeria, providing quality and affordable products and services for now and future generations. Our mission: to contribute to creating a sustainable environmental and infrastructural project that engenders socio-economic development. Our core values: efficiency and quality, professionalism, customer success, and sustainability. Procurement service, your number one trusted source for procurement and supply of equipment, machinery, instruments, materials, manpower, and other consumable items. Our cleaning services, we offer a wide range of cleaning services that includes residential and commercial, janitorial, carpet, office and other specialty cleaning services. Our construction services, our construction team is made up of qualified and experienced professionals who bring latest advances in construction to ensure a sustainable project delivery. You can visit our website at www.kelmao.com or email us at info@kelmao.com, Instagram or Facebook at Kelmao_cleaning services. You can also visit our office at number 546 Constitution Avenue, Central Business.
The awardee will be no other person than Ado Ahmed Gidan Dabino. Gidan Dabino International Nigeria Limited. Ah, Baba, he came ready.
Ado Ahmed Gidan Dabino, MON, Chairman, Chief Executive, Gidan Dabino International Nigeria Limited. Having learned that I am honored with this prestigious award, I feel happy and assure myself that I am doing something worthy or into which I am recognized based on merit. Hard working, dedication, self-sacrifice, and helping hand to those in need. I dedicate this award to industrious personalities without having higher academic certifications.
But don't let you must be a party leader.
You're not so my fiat.
But I haven't done. That's your phone.
Na 20 lokacin mulkin turawan mallaka a kasar Jadarwa. Babban tashin hankali a wancan lokaci shine biyan jangali da haraji. Africa.
Asirin ya gama turuwa.
Joyan sarauta.
Well, something. On the satellite dish, I don't want to mention names. Many people said they give them adverts for free. Thank you. But this is absolutely different, right? I mean, this is riveting. The sound, the movement, everything. I mean, you would want to watch it, right? Wow, this is beautiful. Please, you let us know later how we can get to watch it. I mean, I'm going to sell myself. I'm an actor. In case you need an English-speaking actor like me, you know what I'm saying? Just come over, you know. I'll learn some more hours here and there. But that was beautiful. Thank you so much. Is non-banking financial institution, specifically Leeson. And with that sound, we will introduce who the awardee is. No other person than Ayokunmi Olugbemiro of Liberto Leeson Limited. Let's keep clapping for her. She comes up. Congratulations, Changemaker. Category is a very, very important one. Very important category. Which is, so somebody's giving me signal. If a woman gives you signal, you will understand better than when a man is giving you signal. So let us see who the nominees are for this particular category.
In the maritime category, the nominees are Nasir Salawa, Managing Director, Aqua Shoal Marine Services Limited; Irugama Weifu, Managing Director and CEO of Stars Investment Company Limited; Bob Chukwuemeka, CEO, King Shipping Trading Maritime Services; Olusegun Adetuyi, Director, Maritime Nigeria Limited; and Fatumi Balasti, GND, Bewat Group.
If you love this huge... Okay, so let me just chill for just a bit. I think we have to come back to the maritime industry, if you don't mind. Three is no other person than Irogama B. Obeifun of Stars Investment Company Limited. Let's put our hands together. You look amazing, young woman. Absolutely amazing.
My name is Irogama Ogbaifun, and I am the MD CEO of Stars Investments Company Limited. How do I feel about this award scheme? I think that it is a worthy platform, and it is an avenue to highlight and recognize the efforts and the actions of CEOs around various industries across sectors who are transforming and making a change, impacting and excelling in their various fields of endeavor. So I think it's a worthy platform, and it should be acclaimed. Secondly, good governance practices. First of all, high level of integrity, because that is what keeps the business and the brand name sustainable. It is what grows your business. It speaks for you in your absence. It is what builds your reputation, and it's what builds the brand of your company. So integrity has been has definitely been something that we've exercised as a company and even as individuals, and me personally. We preach it and we practice it. I dedicate this award to my father because he has given me the platform to thrive, he has given me the platform to grow, and I stand on his shoulders. Thank you.
Smart, intelligent, go-getter, kind-hearted giver, beauty with brains, bold, a leader, mentor, are the words to describe Ayo. A standing ovation to one of Nigeria's leading CEOs, Ayo. With a beauty with brains, bold, a leader, mentor, are the words to describe Ayo. A standing ovation to one of Nigeria's leading CEOs, Ayo. Ayokumi Olugbimiro is the founder and visionary of Liberta Leasing, a customer finance technology company optimized to make financing and credit more accessible to Africans. A fintech enthusiast and astute entrepreneur, Ayokumi is also the founder of Nira, a one-stop shop mobile application that offers a wide range of payments, informational and lifestyle services. With over a decade of broad experience in finance and investment industry, Ayokumi is well-versed in sales and marketing management, business development, credit and investment strategies to lead product design, development and business growth. Renowned for her expertise in structuring finances for business, she is also a dynamic leader with a record of outstanding performance in diverse roles.
Okay, let's put our hands together.
Businesses, SMEs, MSMEs, and individuals. We also offer financial advisory to businesses to be able to know what profitable venture they need to go into if the business they're doing is quite profitable and can actually...
Gym and fitness. We love to look good. We love to feel good. No other person than Simi Williams of Beyond Fitness.
To get stronger physically, mentally, emotionally, Beyond is for you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
There's a place for you here. I'm so excited about Beyond because of its inspiring and encouraging community. We hold each other accountable to a higher standard. We celebrate our wins and embrace progress over perfection.
In the shipping and logistics category, nominees are Lawrence Lugovia, CEO, Havila Maritime Services, Rogama Limited, MDC, Stars Investment Company Limited, Chris Mukwota, Managing Director, Blue Seas Maritime Services Limited, Fatomiola Steven, GMD, Bewa Kuri, and Bem Ibrahim Kadwa, MDC.
And the award goes to Stephen Fatomilola of VWAT Shipping Limited. Let's put hands together for the man who said, let me not say what he said. Those of us who came here, let me know what he said. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
right, let's take a look at this next category quickly.
The nominees are Tunde Oyekola, CEO Elmasu Atelier, Olajumoke Adeleye, CEO Ad Consulting Limited, Mosu Ogunbanu, CEO MoArt Architecture, Naiyo Badin, CEO Forces Nigeria Limited, and Mr. Obey Iyamapo, Principal Armark Consultants.
And let's put our hands together for no other person than Obehi Aye Richard Iyamabo of Amra Consultants. Gentlemen, let's go to the next category right now, which is media. This time around, broadcasting. That's true. I suppose I lose the person well, because who knows? If you just jump the person tomorrow night for an interview, who will not remember? Remember that day you were supposed to introduce me properly, young woman? You didn't do that. Why? So I better.
In the media broadcasting category, the nominees are Agatha Amata, CEO. TV, Unduka Obiabena, COM, CEO, Arise News, Wale Adenuga, Founder, Wale Adenuga Productions Limited, Tatiana Musali, CEO, Wazobia TV and Wazobia Max, and Adiremi, CEO, IPS TV.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for no other person than the person I'm actually following on LinkedIn, up and down, and watching what he posts on LinkedIn, just so he knows that I'm following on LinkedIn. Thank you. Aderemi Ogunpitan of IPS Limited. Okay, he's a representative.
IBST is a creative production company with offices in Lagos, Nigeria, with partners and clients across the globe who seek to utilize cutting-edge technology to create, produce, and deliver exciting and engaging digital video content for various online, broadcast, and social media applications and platforms. Our objectives are to tell amazing stories, produce exciting, experiential and audiovisual content using our innovation, creativity and technology to enable you to create a diverse segment of audiences and customers. We have a track record of producing video, audiovisual and digital content that connects with your customers and audiences at any location on any device or platform. Having delivered content projects for local and international clients, we understand what it takes to develop and craft stories and experiences that resonate. That's what we do and who we are. Your elevator pitch, your heartbeat distilled as we provide our services to clients who want to tell powerful stories, grab attention, and invoke action. Whatever your requirements, a branded TV program, corporate video, hybrid event, multi-location live audio-visual event, live streaming or other forms, your purpose and goals are always the same as ours, which is to translate your values to a high-quality production delivery with optimum audience and customer attention. We live in a world where if you want to be remembered, you must be unique and memorable. That's what we help you do at IBST.
Gentlemen, that's a very good export. Yes. So the awardee for this particular category is no other person than Noura Habibo of Five Star Export Import Limited. Hey. one coming out.
He is the CEO of Five Star Export and Import.
You have Mr. Nuran.
Five Star is a reputable exporter of Nigerian dry beans, especially black eye beans, soya beans, tiger nut, hibiscus, garlic, granite, ginger.
Let's put a pause on this and go to the next category, and then manufacturing, specifically roofing. Do we have the nominees for the categories? Good.
Roofing category. The nominees are Chidose Ogbo, CEO, Majestic Tiles Limited. Engineer Ayu, CEO, Imran Roofing and Properties. Wilson Chidose Inwanko, CEO, Wichtech Industries Limited. Patrick Quine, owner, Authentic Roofing Company, and Kehinde Adeleke, Director, Classical Aluminium and Metal Products Limited.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for Engineer Adeboyega Ayub of Imran Roofing and Properties. He's even wearing his brand all over him. Ah, bros. Master seller.
You need an expert to handle the roofing sheets. You need an expert to handle the roofing sheets, distribution and installation. At Imran Roofings, we are a reputable roofing company that process, sells, supply and install various quality roofing sheets, such as tow-coated roofing tiles, aluminium roofing sheets, PVC rain collectors and other roofing materials. Our stone-coated roofing materials is of standard and quality, and it has more than 60 years of durability without fading or rust. We as well process most of our roofing sheets in our warehouse, serving our customers the very best when it comes to roof construction. For more inquiries, you can reach us on...
All right, ladies. Waste management.
Waste management category. The nominees are Hamid Harabin, CEO, Kadma Waste Recycling, Akinduro Kanu, MD, Agua Waste Management Company, Olugenga Adibola, CEO, Big Boy Environmental Services, Oluwatoyin Olatunji, CEO, Urban Spirit Limited, and David Omorede, CEO, Eliezer Facility Management Company.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for David Corey Day of Eliezer Facility Management Company. As he comes to get his recognition, Keto Besong Travels and Tours. Thank you, gentlemen.
A flight reservations and air ticketing services without hassle. Welcome to Naviv Travel, your global travel management solution provider. We make your travel and study dream come life with our tailor-made solutions. We are also a registered organization with offices in Nigeria and Cameroon. With over 20 years of experience in the travel sector, Laviv Travels gives you more flexibility, power, and freedom to achieve your career in travel.
You don't finish, Oga. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. There's no other person than Princess Adekpeju Bemi Ogunleye of Peter and Jane Limited. Let's put our hands together for her. Let's encourage her. Put our hands together for
Princess
her. Thank you so much.
Is a proficient medical laboratory scientist, an astute entrepreneur, the CEO and founder of Peter and Jane Limited and Omics Diagnostics Limited, the two multi-billion naira quoted businesses currently playing big in the African medical landscape, a royal princess from the cradle of Yoruba land, Ile Ife, a devoted mother of two camps. She is a licensed practitioner of neurolinguistics programming, an associate member of the famous Medical Laboratory Science Council of Nigeria, a member of African Liver Patients Association, a voting member of World Hepatitis Alliance, as well as She Achievers Network. She has received numerous recognition, sponsorship, and appreciation awards in and outside Nigeria. Some of her recognition and sponsorship awards include, but not limited to, the Nigerian Institute of Medical Research Chair Award 3 years in a row, 2020, 2021, and 2022. Award of Excellence by Nigerian Excellence Award, Faith Foundation Entrepreneur of the Year 2021. Her foundation, Shekhar Foundation, is a non-profit organization dedicated to the development of public awareness, prevention, and care for people living with viral hepatitis and related cancers. The foundation was awarded the Outstanding NGO in 2016 by the Nigerian Excellence Award and has kept doing amazing work in that space. One of our company, Peter and Jane Limited, partners with many global medical brands and is in collaboration with the Lagos State Ministry of Health, as well as the Nigerian Institute of Medical Research, in managing and controlling the spread of COVID-19 virus, providing them high-level genetics and sequencing support. She is a loving philanthropist, an unapologetic patriot, and an energetic, zealous change maker. She continues to drive herself, her people, and her nation towards a future where everyone lives the best kind of life possible.
You can feel the energy already. Together for Tracy Apana E of Legal Lex, CEA and Associates. That's a representative coming to collect the award, in case you are saying, man, Tracy K. Calm down, it's a rep. Thank you. Innovation. Let us put our hands together for Mayowa Okegbele of Prison Africa. Let's put our hands together. They deserve a round of applause. A huge well done for the good job. Ladies and gentlemen, that's a huge well done. Just turn to your left or to your right. If there's anybody that has gotten an award on your table, just turn to the person and...
Executive Officer for Press One Africa. Press One is a customer service infrastructure for entrepreneurs to offer world-class customer service at a fraction of the cost. 81% of consumers say that a positive customer experience increases their chances of making a purchase. Whether you're a one-man business or a fast-growing one, you can plug into PressOne and improve your customer service and brand experience. Our agents are constantly trained and reviewed periodically to ensure you never have to worry about who picks your call or what they say to customers. With just 25,000 Naira per month, your business, no matter the size, can now offer world-class customer service experience. All you have to do is visit www.pressone.africa or scan the barcode. Very honored to be receiving this award. I think the award celebrates business executives that are working hard to improve how we do business and make contributions to the body of knowledge around proper business practices. So I think this award goes a long way in encouraging all executives to perform at elite levels and do things right. Being associated with an elite group of CEOs by virtue of this award, it's something I'm really thankful for. It's an amazing feeling. A few years ago, I started documenting my thoughts and processes around business and innovation on my blog, innovatorsfriend.com. What I want to dedicate my life to is working with innovators.
All right, thank you so much. I want to hear that. Yeah, that sounds like it. That's good. Absolutely amazing. Clothes, but the people actually make this good clothes possible. And human beings like you and I, they go through the challenges that we go through. And some of them have started receiving bad boos from people. I'm seeing online where people are going to their tailors to slap and fight them over the Christmas cloth that they've not completed, that they've given to them over 2 months ago. How many of you have received such nice, how do I put the word now? Such nice stories from your tailors, be it the guy suits, your dress is going to be ready in 2 weeks. I will make and wear me fine. And you call the best in 3 weeks later, you forgot to know. And the person is actually wonderful. Oh. Amazing set of, wow. I like a set of, in our midst, actually, who will be recognized this evening. And we are saying well done to her for doing a great job and being a game changer in the fashion academy industry. No other person than Kelechi Princess of GMYT.
Here in Lagos, at the 10th anniversary of the GMYT Foundation's 10th anniversary of empowering young people, women in skills acquisition and enterprise. In all, more than 100, or rather 1,000 graduates of the Group Fashion Academy received brand new sewing machines and scholarships, while distinguished personalities from various walks of life were honored for their contributions to diverse charitable enterprises in Nigeria and a number of African countries. It was an event that reflected the beauty of art and fashion, and those that were part of it expressed appreciation and gave honor to whom it was due.
Over the years, the GAA Award Initiative has also achieved 9 out of the 17 United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. These are evident in the empowerment of over 12,000 women and youth with skill empowerment in fashion design and entrepreneurship training, free hostel accommodation, grants, and startup capital. Furthermore, GAA Award has also championed the distribution of 3,000 industrial and domestic sewing machines to empower the next generation of fashion entrepreneurs through the GMI Foundation. In addition, with a focus on the ultimate goal of training 10,000 more women and youth by 2030, we intend to kick off the 23 agenda of empowering 1,000 women and youth with skill empowerment in fashion design, fashionpreneurship, free machines, startup capital, grants, free hostel accommodation, and so much more.
This is the 10th year of the empowerment program that we do in GMI Fashion Academy, and for this one, we did quite a lot. The entire team have been on this for months, you know, just to ensure that we put out the best, because that's what we're known for, the best in GMI Fashion Academy. So a lot of work has actually gone into this.
I came across it on Instagram. I was scrolling, then I saw GMI Fashion, and I was like, I saw one of their, like, last year students who graduated. Yes, sir. So I just like the video and I follow up. So I've been following up on the page till I just come across this scholarship opportunity.
I'm really happy that something like this is happening. I've been sort of following GMI for a while now, and I did not know anything about the scholarship, and I was just going through Instagram and I saw them and I was like, wow. I mean, it's hard to believe that. I feel like fashion, it can be very underrated in Nigeria right now, and the fact that there's something like this for people who actually believe they have a future in fashion is absolutely amazing.
So yeah, I would love to say a very big thank you to Princess Kelechi again, because this is an avenue that is very rare. I've not seen a fashion school that has given this kind of an opportunity before. So it's a very rare opportunity, and I'm so, so glad. I'm happy.
Absolutely. Fashion is.
Come on, yes.
Yeah, my name is Wale Ge. I'm representing a global t-shirt factory, Nigeria Limited, and I'm very grateful for this award. Like, it will improve, you know, the image of the company, like, as in will be more respected in the industry. Like, you know, this award will go a long way, you know, boosting the image of the company. And I want to advise you, upcoming CEOs, that, you know, they should not limit themselves. They should always believe that, you know, whatever they, you know, they dream about, it can still come to pass. There should be the will to win in every aspect of their life. Thank you.
All right, no problem. Well, my name is Kayode Daniels. I am representing Aderemi Ogunpeyi of IBST Media. I think it's a great honor to Mr. Aderemi, and it shows that you know, the good deeds that we're doing as a company, and he himself as a CEO, is being recognized. And I say a good kudos to the organizers. I would say that this recognition is one that will go so far, you know, into incorporating, you know, togetherness as entrepreneurs and business owners in Nigeria. I believe the government can do more. There's always room for improvement. I believe there's also a lot that we can do on our own parts as, you know, private owners of businesses. But yeah, it's a collective effort on both ends.
Any advice for the upcoming
CEOs? Okay, I would say put in the good work, continue to put in the good work. And for the CEOs, your staff are the ones that make you who you are, and always consider them. Finally, my name is Kayode Daniels. Thank you very much.
You want to be an insert?
So what's the question going to be?
Yeah, I will ask you the question.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Good evening, sir.
Thank you very much. My name is BC Teru. I am the CEO of Dust and Wipes Limited. The awards are always a welcomed idea. It shows that you are doing something good somewhere. Being a CEO can be very challenging. It can be very, very demanding. But at the end of the day, if you get to hear that somebody somewhere actually sees that you're doing well, it makes you feel really good about it.
How would the award impact your business and your life?
Oh, I mean, every recognition is always a plus to your business. You want to be able to tell the world that we were recognized for something good at some point in time, you know. So it's definitely a plus for business growth. Oh, yes, and I could talk forever on that, you know, if I'm going to be giving advice to upcoming CEOs. The first thing I'm going to say is don't give it up, you know. Don't give up the dream. Don't give up the ideas. Stick to it. We live in a country where the factors that seem to fight against you, seem to come against you on a daily basis, makes you want to actually drop off the dream and, you know, look for something else. You know, every CEO has a story, and I have mine as well. So the first thing I'm going to say is don't give up. You know, it's going to come, the tides will come, the storm will come. You've got to stand strong in it. You've probably got to maybe seek counsel, seek advice from people you maybe look forward or look up to, people you see as mentors, people you see as older ones, or, you know, senior colleagues in this business. And sometimes you probably might need their lead and their guide. Thank you. My name, once again, is BC Teru. I'm the CEO of Dust and Wipes Limited.
I just want to say
higher.
Simi Williams. Okay. Simi Williams, CEO of Beyond Fitness. I feel grateful and honored. It's a privilege to be among other phenomenal entrepreneurs that are working hard and creating a difference and impact in Nigeria. I think it's helpful to get encouraged when working very hard. And it's also great to show this to other entrepreneurs, to encourage them, because it's not easy. And I feel privileged to be recognized. And it's inspiring as well to keep going and do even more. Absolutely. Just don't give up. I think the three P's, you know, passion, perseverance, prayers really help. So don't give up. I think they're trying, and I know that they can do more. You know, baby steps, every incremental initiative that helps entrepreneurs, from financing to enhancing regulation, will go a long way. So Simi Williams, CEO of Beyond Fitness.
Thank you very much. Okay, my name is Ayokunumi Olugbemiro, CEO Libertalism Limited, CEO Nira Payments Limited. How can you say about your mission? Okay, I feel elated. It's quite interesting being honored and recognized as one of the most respected CEO in Nigeria. It's really amazing, and it's good, I can say, for the recognition, it's good. Okay, so Libertalism Limited is a consumer finance firm that provides access to credit to Africans, and also we also have a special package which is called the Better Power Loan for women, which will give them low interest rate and also train them on how to be able to be profitable, to also be able to pay back their loan. So it is a consumer finance company. It's what we give credit, we give access to credit, any kind of loan, business loan, LPO financing, salary advance, what kind of loan, we're always there for you. Wow. Okay, so to upcoming CEOs, what I can say is that the road will always be tough, but persistent consistency will keep you going and will get you there. And I always say something, don't give up, no matter the challenges. In fact, so one of my rules to life is the more the challenges, the more the glory, so the better the glory. So when you have more challenges, that is when you will be more recognized. So I'll say don't give up, just keep moving forward. Consistency, focus, and God will get you there. My name is Ayokunumi Olugbemiro, CEO Libertalism Limited. Thank you very much.
Yes, my name is Ogunride Olayinka Oluwole. I'm the managing director of Harmonware Company Limited. Well, I feel elated, very wonderful that this award could come to a Nigerian company, a wholly owned company like Harmonware Company Limited. In fact, I appreciate the Almighty God and the organizer of the award given to Nigerian in Nigeria. This is wonderful, especially to SME, recognizing impact of SMEs in contributions to Nigerian sector, in various sectors like agriculture, agrochemical, movies, and entertainment. It's wonderful. I'm so happy. Yes, my advice to the upcoming CEOs is to stand focused and create standard in whatsoever they offer. Because if you look at the foreign company coming to Nigeria, what they have brought to Nigeria that make Nigeria to recognize whatever they brought to us is standard. So as a Nigerian company, the heads of companies in Nigeria should think towards standard, be focused, and believe in whatsoever we have, from our local content. Ogunride Olayinka Oluwole, Managing Director, Chief Executive, Ammonwell Company Limited. Thank you.
Hold it like that. All right,
so my name is Keto Bisong. I'm the CEO of Laviv Travels Limited. I'm excited because it is the very first time receiving an award in this travel and tours category. I really appreciate the Almighty God for this excellent opportunity.
Now, how will the award impact your business? What will be the impact of the award on your business and you personally?
Yeah, the award is going to be an eye-opener in my business, in the sense that it's going to boost the integrity of the business, irrespective of the challenges that the industry has faced or the company has and the entity has faced.
Do you think government is doing enough concerning their contribution
to the SMEs, or do you think they still need to do more? I can't totally say that government is not doing anything. To a greater extent, the government is doing enough, but they need to do more in order to promote SMEs, especially for those rendering services. Governments find it very difficult to promote people rendering services, organizational rendering services like ours. Rather, they promote those that deal with products and stocks.
Now, we have upcoming CEOs. And what do you think you can tell them to motivate this
movement? What I can tell the upcoming CEO is they should stay focused. And whatever thing they are doing, they should do it with a touch of excellence.
No matter how long it takes them.
Yes.
Thank you. Your name again?
My name is Keto Bisong, the CEO of Laviv Travels Limited.
Can I have your card because of your name? So that I won't wrongly spell your name. And if we are done with it, we can just send some more for
you. All right. Thank you very much.
But we can also invite you for a business program in our station.
Yes, I will come in contact with it. I will not be
finished. But you are used to
I don't have a branch office yet, but I hope to have one. But anytime you call on me, I will.
We can also have Zoom.
Okay, no problem.
If that is it, it's not convenient for you to be in Lagos at that time.
Thank you.
I have come in Zoom. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. That's it.
This one is for my day. Thanks very much.
My name is Maureen Kelechi Onkwe, CEO Kelmal Global Services Nigeria Limited. I am so grateful, I am so happy, and I must thank the organizers of this award for finding me worthy to receive such an award. And I must say kudos to them. Yes, it's good for an organization like this, a reputable organization like this, to recognize people that are really doing well in different endeavors. So I think it's a good one and I must commend them.
What's the name of the company?
Okay, the name of my company is Kelmal Global Services Nigeria Limited. Okay, we are into three things. We do procurement. We do industrial cleaning and fumigation, and we also do construction. So is a very large company that have all this aspect they indulge in.
Engineer Adebeg Ayub, CEO of Imran Roofing. Imran Roofing and Properties.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm very grateful about the award because what I just believe in life is that anything you are doing, integrity first. Because the integrity that I show in my business, I think that is what I lead it to this award. And I'm very grateful and I really appreciate the award.
What can you say about it?
Yeah, I think it's well organized because I can remember last year they also present award to me, but due to one thing or another, I'm not able to show up. But thank God for this year, I'm here. So I think it's okay. You're welcome, sir.
My name is Olatunji Onadija. So, okay. My name is Olatunji Onadija. I'm the CEO and founder of TechVantage Innovations, a software startup based in Abuja, Nigeria.
So how do you feel about this award?
I feel pleased, honored, and humbled to win this award. It's an honor to be considered among a lot of industry titans that are doing very well in their respective fields. I'm really pleased to win this award, and it's an honor. Yeah, the organizers of the award, Nigeria's Most Respected CEOs Award, they've done a spectacular job at putting together a wonderful event. Special shout out to them for putting this together. And thank you for the award. So at TechVantage, we are web constructors. We develop websites, apps, mobile apps, all types of internet services, ICT staffing, and all of that. That's what we do.
Okay, my name is Oluwatobi Oladele. Okay, I should start again. My name is Oluwatobi Oladele, CEO of FIPS Multilinks Limited, the real estate development company in Lagos here. We also are present in Ghana and in Canada here.
How do you feel about this award?
Oh, well, we feel so honored. So honored to be part of this award. And we believe this award will further position us to the global scale, which is part of our company, which we envisage.
What do you have to say about this?
Come again? Okay. Oh, they are great. I mean, thank you so much for recognizing us, for seeing us, and for seeing the little things that we do, and counting it worthy to be given this award. We appreciate them.
My name is Architect Obehi Yamabo. I'm the principal partner of Amak Consultants, a firm of consulting architects. Well, I feel honored. It's some kind of recognition for the work that we have done. And even though I cannot say I'm the best in the industry, but I feel honored that we are having some kind of recognition.
Okay. What do you say about this?
Well, I think what they're doing is commendable. It's a big encouragement for people in the industry. For them to see that the works they've done in private are being celebrated in public. It's a very complex thing. It's a very complex thing. And as head of the building industry, well, I cannot blame the public for blaming the architect, because we do have a lot of responsibility. But it's a cocktail. You have the consultant, you have the contractor, and then you have the government regulatory agencies as well. So we all have a lot of work to do, and most of the problems we've had have been as a result of unqualified personnel, unqualified architects, unqualified builders, and then people who try and circumvent the building process. So government being the actual regulatory authority, they have the power to stop most of these quacks. But on our part, we will continue to give the absolute best we can professionally, and help the government as best as we can. How can we help government? By reporting. First of all, we have in-house training, okay? There's a certain level of training and qualification that you must have to practice as an architect. So when the government itself also helps us to ensure that only qualified architects are allowed to practice. Now, we cannot go on the streets and go start harassing people. The government, that's why I use the word regulatory authorities. The government has a big responsibility to play. And then we are, of course, available to help the government in their regulatory responsibilities.
Hello, good day. My name is Kingsley Ejiofor. I'm representing my director, Mr. Ahmadiok Ajoku Obi. He's the founder of Udibia. Udibia is a telecom brand, telemedicine specifically, and we've had track records in the industry, helping lives, helping humanity to save lives and, you know, advance the cause of medical, you know, telehealth in Nigeria. This award today will be, you know, a great recognition to Dr. Ahmadiok, you know, to Dr. Ahmadiok Obi to, you know, recognize his impact in the telemedicine sector of Nigeria. He has actually, you know, created a lot of top-notch brands, especially his BP monitors, which he created, which are top-notch, which does not have any other replica in Africa. It has been recognized globally, you know, because it was a thorough sat-down, you know, concept he had, developed it, and then there's a new concept he's working on right now, which will be coming out by next year, 2023. It's a weighing scale that has about 23 other functions. It does. So it does not just do normal weighing scale people do, but it has other functions. The whole essence is to advance Africa. The whole essence is to save humanity. The whole essence is to cut down this maternal mortality, infant mortality, you know, the rate of death rates coming on in Africa. We're not crash it. We're not make sure we save lives to prolong the lifespan of Africans and Nigerians in particular. So Udibia is here to stay. You can check up our website, www.udibia.com. We have a lot of products and services meant to advance humanity, advance lifespan, and save lives in Africa. You know, so we are here to, you know, thank God for the recognition they've given to Udibia, which is a testament to, you know, good works Udibia have been doing. We've received a couple of awards this year. I think this should be the fourth award we are receiving this year. You know, a testament of good works we are doing, and it's an encouragement. Sometimes when you check the, you know, technicalities and the difficulties in the business terrain in Nigeria, and sometimes you're feeling a little bit weighed down, you know, based on a couple of, you know, challenges in operations. But this kind of awards gives the morale, gives, you know, morale boosting to, you know, the entrepreneur, gives morale boosting to, you know, to forge ahead, to go forward, and to keep on advancing in what we are doing. So Udibia is here to come, you know, is here to stay. We are here, and we are advancing life. So thank you, NTA. Thank you for the good job, and the NG boards, and the whole management of the Merit Award. It's a pleasure to be here, and we are grateful. Thank you.
My name is Damilola Ilelorun-Dangoni. I'm the CEO of Cyber Technology Limited here in Nigeria. So it is an artificial intelligence company where we address the global healthcare issues. So we're actually working on a project called CyberLife. CyberLife is an artificial intelligence solution that addresses the wrong diagnosis, accurate decryption, and precision medicine. I feel fulfilled and happy. I'm very happy about that because I see it as a stepping stone and worth seeing that, oh, Javelin, I'm actually working on something.
Okay, what do you want to say about the Udibia Awards?
Oh, fine. They are very fantastic people, especially Mr. Wonsu, which is one of the key organizers of the event. He has been one of the best person I ever met on it. The care, the follow-up, the attention, the details. I'm really very happy about the organization, and I give them kudos, and they should keep doing the good job. Of Cyber.Technology. Cyber.Technology is an artificial intelligence company that addresses the world global problem. So we try, right now we are working on healthcare solution, whereas we are addressing the accurate diagnosis, precision medicine, you know, out-of-pocket spending. So it is a solution that already even gotten attention in Europe, in United States, in California precisely. So even the AI for 2022, this solution has been featured in the magazine.
Myself, Myself, Chief Dr. Kamlesh Jain. I am CEO of Excelmind Corporate Services. We are into HR services and recruiting related to any kind of a field, oil and gas, and you go any kind of industry, we are there for the HR services. And this award is really very prestigious, and I'm really, I would like to congratulate to the organizer for organizing such an accomplished event, because I think this is the way you motivate others to come forward and work towards the betterment of community and country.
You based in Nigeria?
I'm based in Nigeria.
How do you see Nigeria environment in terms of business? So you are in oil and gas, or yes, how do you see the government can support
this? I feel that Nigeria has a lot of potential. The potential has to tap in. It's such a fertile land in terms of, I would say, human resources, oil and gas. You have all the kind of minerals you have. Basically, you have all kind of resources. You have an abundance in land, you know, the farming, agriculture. Everywhere there is abundance. So it's just that you need to tap in. The government has to come in, ask for more investment from foreign land coming to this country. And I think this is going to be the best place to live.
How do you think the government can come in, can help?
The government can help by making those procedures for investment easy, the banking system to be focused, and I believe they should ease out on duties so that, you know, they can attract more investment coming to Nigeria. And one more thing I would like to say, little more disciplined in their work should bring the moral lot of things in that.
Thank you.
All right, my name is Ladi Bulus. I am the founder and CEO of Ladi Moras Integrated Farms Limited.
How do you feel about this award?
I feel so excited, you know, to have been nominated and elected for such a prestigious award. I am so happy. In fact, when I received the email, I was like, oh, does this require me to go to Lagos? But then after I thought about it, I was like, I have to go. It's not an opportunity that I can miss. So I'm so excited right now.
Where are you from? Lagos?
I'm from Kaduna State, sir. Yes, sir.
What do you say about them?
They are really kind, especially with the way they kept following up with emails. And then, I mean, they are all wonderful, all the teams, because I've spoken to, I think, about three of them on the phone. So they are really, they are very kind, with good customer service. So,
do you think they have the right to give people awards?
Anybody, it's more like a thing of appreciation. Even my younger sister can decide today to say, okay, Ladi, I want to appreciate you for the hard work you've been doing. So they are worth it. They can, yes.
Being a farmer, you say a farmer.
Yes, sir.
What do you think government can do for you?
Okay, I think so far, as farmers, we've been trained. We have extension agents coming to our places to teach. Yes, we know we've received that one. But I think what we need currently is beyond training. We need financial empowerment. Because it's more like you have the idea, but then you don't know how to put it into practice, because finance is one of the problems we are facing. So with financial help, I think it will go a long way in not only improving the agricultural sector in Nigeria, but even at the global level.
Talking about financial support.
Yes, sir.
The IBOS and UH or something like that. What do you think the government should establish for farmers, especially to encourage farming?
We have the BOI and other industries that come out to say, okay, they are here for farmers and the likes. But the requirement is too much for a local farmer like me. Imagine you're asking me for several things, at times even my own parents' certificate and other things that possibly they are dead or something. The requirement seems too much for a common farmer like me. I think they should just simplify the requirements, and then they should be follow up to make sure that, okay, this money is being given to the farmers themselves. They should interview them. They should, instead of sending their agent, they should go in person to ask, okay, did you receive this? So let the farmers testify themselves, because I'm sure the governments are giving out money. Just that we have people that usually cut the money, and the money is not getting to the farmers themselves. Ladi Bulus, I'm Ladi Bulus. Thank you.
My name is Stephen Fatumola Olumayowa. I'm the MD of the Watt Shipping Limited. And of course, I'm here for the Best CEO Award for Maritime in the industry where I work. And of course, I'm very glad for me to be considered as one of the awardees. I think doing so will avail me of the opportunity to meet with the airlines, of course, the federal government as well, to discuss with them on how best we can move the maritime industry forward, better than how it is now.
Okay, what is your award for them that give you the award? How do you see the procedure?
Well, of course, it's a very good one. To be honest with you, they did a thorough job for them to have actually ascertained that, of course, certain person win the award for this category. It was actually a very tough one, to be honest with you. I never knew that, of course, that award could actually come to me. As at the time they called me that the award has been, that I have won the award, I actually asked them, what are the yardstick you use? Of course, they told me a whole lot of things that many things were considered before Viva Shipping MD was considered for the award. Thank you.
And what's your message for them?
Well, my message for them is for them to actually go outside the shore of this maritime industry. To be honest with you, after this award night, I'm going to actually have a personal engagement with the MD, the management of this body, to see how best this thing can actually be moved forward than how it is now. I think I have to commend them. They've done a good job.
How do you frame maritime?
Well, maritime, you know, like it's, as it speaks, it has to do with anything that has to do with, of course, seagoing. I work in the ports. Coincidentally, I'm the general secretary of the Lagos Priority District, Tinkan Island Port. I've been on this position for quite a while. So maritime, to be honest with you, apart from all, maritime should be another source of income of this country. And I know if federal governments actually do well in this particular industry, to be honest with you, we are, you know, foreign bodies will be competing with us.
My name is Ado Ahmed Gidandebino, MON, from Kano, Chairman, Chief Executive of Gidandebino International Nigeria Limited. I feel happy and very excited about this award because I don't know the organizers of this award. I haven't ever across their name, so I don't know where they find my name. Maybe I know online or some newspaper, because I'm a producer, director, an actor, and then I'm a writer, publisher. So maybe somewhere somebody interview me, so that's why they find my name. So that's what I'm saying. I'm very happy for that.
So with this award now, yeah, what do you think you can do more to
I will improve my work, because as I said, I started producing or writing of books since 1990, for over 32 years as a writer. I published over 15 novels, 18 films, so I will try to produce more and more films and books. More especially, I'm growing up in young writers and young producers or artists in my area, that's Kano. So I will look far away from me, not only near to me, to grow up the youngest generation, because I am 58 years now. So maybe I'm going to retire maybe in the next some years. So I'll try my best because of this award. I spent over 12 years before I came to Lagos. So I come purposely for this award from Kano. So definitely I enjoy it. I will try to improve my work, pertaining writing and film production. That's what I'm saying. I wrote my first novel is In the Soda Corner, but the translation version is The Soul of My Heart, and Maso and them in that is Nemesis. So, and then there is another one about drug abuse. The name of the title of the book is young woman, substance abuse, and the way out. So I write about the women who are into drugs abuse. So. We produce one film. It's about kingmakers in northern Nigeria. How the woman roll into the coup in the palace. So that's why we are calling it coup, palace coup in Hausa, Jew in Sarauta. So we won 36 awards. After now, we didn't release the film due to the problem of the market. So now we are looking for the distributors outside Nigeria because I can remember I show my film in UK, that is Hamburg, SOAS University, and Hamburg University, New Delhi, and Warsaw in Poland. So we are trying to see that this new film, we are calling the government to assist us or to invest into business industry called PIM production. I know some years back during Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, there are so many millions or billions of naira in Project Nollywood Art. They assist many of the producers. Even in our area, in Kano, Kaduna, Jos, and other states, they get the fund. So we wish the other government will come now. We are hoping to invest into the industry, entertainment industry.
So before you comment to people that give you the award, what do you have to say about them?
What?
People that gave you this award now.
Who?
People that gave you this award, what do you have to say about them?
So I'm very happy. Thank you for Nigerian business executive, because they don't know me, I don't know them. So just I saw my name in the list, we are 13 in the nomination. So, and then I would like to thank my people who bought me mass voting. That's why I become a winner. So I would like to call for the organizers, try to look far away from Lagos and other states. For instance, I'm in Kano, I don't know them. Mostly my film is in Hausa, so they don't care about what language are you producing or what language are you writing for. We are all Nigerians. We are all promoting our language, our culture, and business.
So, film and writing.
Yeah.
Is there any difference?
Yeah, there's a difference between writing and film. Writing is a matter of brain. If you don't have a brain, you cannot write. I can be a producer if I have the money. Even I don't have the brain. That's why I say writers are born, not made. I'm a Nobelist. I have 15 Nobels. So you cannot write if you don't have a brain. So you can produce if you don't have brain. If you don't have a brain, but you have the money. So forget about the artist. So it's a nature. You understand, like a writer, artists are born. Some they are learning in the school. You understand me? So that it's too different. Writing is more difficult than producing a film. Yeah, that's the difference.
Okay. Now that writing and film is different.
Yeah.
And what would government to think that this thing, what can this writing and give?
So in Nigeria, most of the time, government, they are giving the support more in the PIM industry, not in the writing. You understand me? Even in our northern Nigerian state, sometimes politicians come into the PIM industry, give the money to promote them, to do campaign, to sing, to other activities in the political issues, but they don't care about the writers, because maybe writers, they don't have anything to do with them. Because if you don't have a knowledge, you cannot write, you cannot read. So, but anybody, anybody can view the film. Anybody can understand the film because photograph is a universal language. If you are watching Indian film, Chinese, and other languages, you can understand. Because if the film is a real film, you can understand. Even you mute the sound because you are moving your body. You are showing description and others. So that's why I'm say federal government. I call for the federal government to look for the writers. I know in the film industry, politicians put money, but they don't care about the writers. We are trying our best to publish, self-publishing. We publish our own books, we distribute our own books. Only few of us, if you get recommendation from the Ministry of Education, that's why that's the time you can sell some more. Forget about me. I publish, I reprint my first novel over 500,000 copies. So that's why they are calling it the best-selling house novel. You understand? Over 500,000. So not all the writer can sell 1,000, 2,000, 5,000. So even now, some university school from KB, Sokoto, Zampara, Kano, Jigawa, up to Nasarawa, they are reading my books because I'm writing in three genres: prose, poetry, and drama. Not all the writer can write in that three genres. Maybe you can write a prose, but you cannot write a drama. Or maybe you can write a drama, you cannot write a poem. So I'm three in one. I am writing drama. I have novels about three. I have play, three books published. And then I have 15 prose. And then I have a one poem book. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah.
Good evening. My name is Ambassador Dr. Oame Royo Hidebe. Well, like I said when I was making my speech, to be a CEO in Nigeria, it's a way lot of tax. And I encourage people not to quit. Because if you can conquer what's happening in Nigeria, you can definitely conquer a lot of countries' challenges and still shine. You know, so the more it is darker here, make your light shine wherever you are. Be good with what you do and make sure it is authentic. Your services, your products, don't try to abuse government policies. It helps you to be upright and diligent. Yeah. You know, I've been partnering with Boz and these event planners, and this one thing with people is you don't understand that it helps you boost your morale to call you to take an award. And they do a lot of voting. They do a lot of investigations before they give their awards. It's not just you pay money to collect award. There's a lot of due diligence being done. So I think they should keep it up. You know, because they are touching lives, they are encouraging people, they are adding value to what people are doing, and they are helping to show that there are good people around, good businesses around, good CEOs around that are weathering the storm. Well, as a security practitioner, I am the National Secretary for Retired Members of Nigerian Armed Forces, and I've advised serially in different television stations, even in your station, that people should be community-wise. Every community must have their resilience plan and their resilience pattern. Because if you say you are APC, PDP, XYZ, when people start to die, it affects everybody, you know, and it may be your brother. So we should make our communities resilient. We should partner with the agencies because whether we like it or not, we don't have another police, another military. These are the ones we have. You know, we should partner with them and we should ensure that we support INEC to do their best. Everyone should vote, and we should pray and work towards every vote counting. Thank you very much. Yeah. My name is Ambassador Dr. Oame Royo Hideve. I'm the National Secretary for Retired Members of Nigerian Armed Forces. Thank you.
I'm tired. My name is Mal. Is it okay? My name is Mawina. I'm coordinating our head of events for the NG Bus Executive. We just organized, or we are the organizers of the prestigious Nigeria Most Respected CEOs Awards. So basically what this awards aims at doing is publicly recognizing outstanding men and women in corporate Nigeria. We want to actually, you know, highlight the works of some of these people to show the world that these people are doing a great job and they're contributing to the economy. So basically that's the aim of this award, Nigeria Most Respected CEOs Awards, and the aim of the company at large. Of course, the company is NG Bus, registered in Nigeria, but externally on the mother umbrella is the Business Executive Media Group, and we are headquartered in Accra, Ghana. Of course, we have branches in Nigeria, and the secretariat is in Abuja. We equally have presence in Dubai, we have presence in South Africa and in Europe, among others. So basically across all the globe or on the various continents we find ourselves, this is what we do. We recognize top CEOs. My name is Mawena. Mawena AJ Diana.
Let's put us together. I'm not joking. All my guys, them know me.
This award is really very prestigious, and I'm really I would like to congratulate to the organizer for organizing such an accomplished event, because I think this is the way you motivate others to come forward and work towards the betterment of community and country. Nigeria has a lot of potential. The potential has to tap in. It's such a fertile land in terms of, I would say, human resources, oil and gas. You have all the kind of minerals you have. Basically, you have all kind of resources. And I think this is going to be the best place to live. The government can help by making those procedures for investment easy, the banking system to be focused, and I believe they should ease out on duties so that, you know, they can attract more investment coming to Nigeria.
I feel happy and very excited about this award, because I don't know the organizers of this award. I haven't ever across their name, so I don't know where they find my name. Maybe I know online or some newspaper. So I come purposely for this award from Kano. So definitely I enjoy it. I will try to improve my work pertaining writing and film production.
I'm very glad for me to be considered as one of the awardees. I think doing so will avail me of the opportunity to meet with the allies, of course the federal government as well, to discuss with them on how best we can move the maritime industry forward, better than how it is now. I think I have to commend them, that they've done a good job.
In fact, when I received the email, I was like, oh, does this require me to go to Lagos? But then after I thought about it, I was like, I have to go. It's not an opportunity that I can miss. So I'm so excited right now.
I'm very happy about the award because I see it as a stepping stone and worth seeing that, oh, Javelin, I'm actually working on something.
I feel pleased, honored, and humbled to win this award. It's an honor to be considered among a lot of industry titans that are doing very well in their respective fields.
What I just believe in life is that anything you are doing, integrity first. Because the integrity that I show in my business, I think that is what that led to this award. And I'm very grateful and I really appreciate the award.
I am so grateful, I am so happy, and I must thank the organizers of this award for finding me worthy to receive such an award. And I must say kudos to them.
First of all, very grateful for this award. Like, it will improve, you know, the image of the complaint. Like, as in, will be more expected in you know, in the industry. Like, you know, this award will go a long way, you know, boosting the image of the complaint. And I want to advise you, upcoming CEOs, that, you know, they should not limit themselves. They should always believe that, you know, whatever they, you know, they dream about, it can still come to pass. There should be the will to win in every aspect of their life.
The good deeds that we're doing as a company and he himself as a CEO is being recognized, and I say a good kudos to the organizers. I would say that this recognition is one that goes so far, you know, into incorporating, you know, togetherness as entrepreneurs and business owners in Nigeria. I believe the government can do more. There's always room for improvement. I believe there's also a lot that we can do on our own parts as, you know, private owners of businesses. But yeah, it's a collective effort on both ends. Okay, I would say put in the good work, continue to put in the good work, and for the CEOs, your staff are the ones that make you who you are, and always consider them.
Every recognition is always a plus to your business. You want to be able to tell the world that we were recognized for something good at some point in time, you know. So it's definitely a plus for business growth. Don't give up. You know, it's going to come, the tides will come, the storm will come. You've got to stand strong in it. You've probably got to maybe seek counsel, seek advice from people you maybe look forward or look up to, people you see as mentors, people you see as older ones, or, you know, senior colleagues in this business. And sometimes you probably might need their lead and their guide.
I feel grateful and honored. It's a privilege to be among other phenomenal entrepreneurs that are working hard and creating a difference and impact in Nigeria. Just don't give up. I think the three P's, you know, passion, perseverance, prayers, really help. So don't give up.
I feel elated. It's quite interesting being honored and recognized as one of the most respected CEO in Nigeria. It's really amazing, and it's good, I can say. For the recognition, it's good. Upcoming CEOs, what I can say is that the road will always be tough, but persistent consistency will keep you going and will get you there. And I always say something, don't give up, no matter the challenges. In fact, so one of my rules to life is the more the challenging, the more the challenges, the more the glory. So the better the glory. So when you have more challenges, that is when you'll be more recognized. So I'll say don't give up. Just keep moving forward.
Well, I feel elated, very wonderful that this award could come to a Nigerian company, a wholly owned company like Amonwell Company Limited. In fact, I appreciate the Almighty God and the organizer of the award given to Nigerian in Nigeria. This is wonderful, especially to SME, recognizing impact of SMEs in contributions to Nigerian sector in various sectors like agriculture, agrochemical, movies, and entertainment. It's wonderful. I'm so happy.
Yeah, the award is going to be an eye-opener in my business, in the sense that it's going to boost the integrity of the business, irrespective of the challenges that the industry has faced or the company has and the entity has faced. To a greater extent, the government is doing enough, but they need to do more in order to promote SMEs, especially for those rendering services. Governments find it very difficult to promote people rendering services, organizational rendering services like ours. Rather, they promote those that deal with products and stocks.
You know, I've been partnering with boards and these event planners, and this one thing with people is you don't understand that it helps you boost your morale to call you to take an award. And they do a lot of voting, they do a lot of investigations before they give their awards. It's not just you pay money to collect award. There's a lot of due diligence being done. So I think they should keep it up. You know, because they are touching lives, they are encouraging people, they are adding value to what people are doing, and they are helping to show that there are good people around, good businesses around, good CEOs around that are weathering the storm. Make your light shine wherever you are. Be good with what you do, and make sure it is authentic. Your services, your products, don't try to abuse government policies. It helps you to be upright and diligent.
Basically, what this awards aims at doing is publicly recognizing outstanding men and women in corporate Nigeria. We want to actually, you know, highlight the works of some of these people to show the world that these people are doing a great job and they're contributing to the economy. The company is NG Bus, registered in Nigeria, but externally on the mother umbrella is the Business Executive Media Group, and we are headquartered in Accra, Ghana. Of course, we have branches in Nigeria, and the secretariat is in Abuja. We equally have presence in Dubai, we have presence in South Africa and in Europe, among others. So basically across all the globe, or on the various continents we find ourselves, this is what we do. We recognize top CEOs. Let's put our hands together. I'm not joking, all my guys, them know.